It's AumSum time!
What happens to our body on a long flight?
No big deal. Nothing can happen to AumSum.
Oh, AumSum. Air circulating in an airplane's cabin is drawn from outside. Now, air at higher altitudes does not contain much moisture. As a result, one can easily become dehydrated. As the airplane climbs, air pressure inside decreases, while when an airplane descends, air pressure inside increases. This can lead to earaches. Also, gases in our bodies expand and contract, depending upon the air pressure. This can lead to headaches as well as much more farting than usual. Now, as we remain immobile for long periods in an airplane, it can lead to development of blood clots in our legs, etc. Finally, long flights can also lead to jet lag as well as greater exposure to cosmic radiation.
To buy AumSum merchandise, visit AumSum.com.
What happens if a plane is struck by lightning?
It will start glowing like a disco ball.
No. Lightning is a massive flow of charge which carries thousands of volts of electric current. Thus, it is extremely fatal for living beings and can damage anything that comes in its way.
Yeah, dude. It is really terrifying.
Now, many times, airplanes get caught in a heavy lightning storm. However, airplanes are designed to handle the lightning strikes. The outer skin of most planes is primarily made of aluminum. Aluminum is a good conductor of electricity. When lightning hits the airplane, the electric current travels through the outer skin of the plane. It does not pass into the plane. Eventually, it exits off through another extremity, such as tail. Thus, the airplane and the passengers within remain protected. Why can't you use phones on planes?
Because phones can fall out of the window.
Nah. It might be because portable electronic devices like cell phones and tablets emit radio signals. These signals can interfere with the flight controls. They may also disrupt the communication with the air traffic controllers on the ground. Besides this, cellular towers are miles below the airplane. Hence, cell phones try to emit a stronger radio signal to detect the network. This can increase the possibility of causing interference with the airplane electronic equipment.
Really? I didn't know that.
Hence, portable electronic devices are told to be either turned off or to be kept on airplane mode or flight mode. This prevents the emission of radio signals, thus helping to keep all the onboard equipment working properly. Why does airplane food taste bad?
I don't know.
Wait, I'll explain. Our ability to perceive taste is affected by a few factors such as humidity, air pressure, etc. In an airplane, the humidity is less as compared to that on the ground. This makes the air in the airplane quite dry. Also, to maintain the air pressure inside and outside the airplane, the air pressure inside it is decreased. Decreased air pressure and dry air dries our nose and mouth. Dry nose cannot properly smell odors.
Yeah, dude, I'm not able to smell the burger.
Now, smell of food helps us to understand the flavor and ingredients of the food. Thus, the food which we cannot smell properly appears unappealing. Also, dry mouth reduces the sensitivity of our taste buds. As a result, we cannot perceive the taste of food properly. Why do airplane wings wobble?
Simple. Because I keep on shaking them.
AumSum. When an aircraft is flying at a constant speed and at a constant altitude, then the same amount of force will be pushing it up as well as down. As in, the net force will be zero. Now, if the plane enters an area of higher air density, say a large cloud, then this would lead to an increase in the force pushing it up. As in, lift force will increase. As a result, the plane is pushed upwards and its wings temporarily bend up in the process. Now, if the plane enters an area of lower density, as in it comes out of the cloud, then the lift force is reduced. As a result, the plane comes down. Its wings bend back down. This sudden change in lift force is what causes the plane wings to wobble. How high can airplanes fly?
Simple. As high as I want.
Oh, AumSum. Commercial airplanes fly at altitudes ranging between 30,000 to 36,000 feet above the sea level. Do you know why? Let me explain. There are two reasons for this. Firstly, flying at such an altitude places the airplane in the lower stratosphere of planet Earth. Lower stratosphere is located above the clouds. This helps in protecting the airplane against bad weather. Secondly, the air in the lower stratosphere is much thinner as compared to the air near the surface of the Earth. Thinner the air, lesser the resistance for the airplane. This results in higher fuel efficiency for the airplane. Hence, commercial airplanes fly so high. What if satellites disappeared?
No problem. Even AumSum can send signals from space.
AumSum. Firstly, if satellites disappeared, televisions will stop receiving signals. Binge watchers might be reduced to tears. Secondly, if satellites disappeared, in-flight phone communications on airplanes will stop working. Thirdly, if satellites disappeared, GPS will stop working. Google Maps will stop working. There will be chaos everywhere. Fourthly, if satellites disappeared, credit cards as well as ATMs will stop working. Businesses will be severely impacted. Fifthly, if satellites disappeared, it will be difficult to monitor hurricanes, volcanic eruptions, burning oil fields, etc. Sixthly, if satellites disappeared, tracking climate change will get difficult as satellites help to monitor ocean temperatures, sea levels, size of glaciers, emissions of greenhouse gases, etc. Lastly, if satellites disappeared, space science will suffer, as telescopes like Hubble Space Telescope, which are used to observe the universe, will also disappear. What if trains disappeared?
No problem. AumSum always flies first class.
AumSum. Firstly, if trains disappeared, sale of cars would skyrocket. Secondly, if trains disappeared, city roads might get heavily congested again. Thirdly, if trains disappeared, cost of traveling might increase as taxis are generally more expensive. Fourthly, modern trains are being built using billions of dollars. If trains disappeared, government's treasury may get empty soon. Lastly, modern trains are being run on clean energy. If trains disappeared, pollution levels might go up. How does an air conditioner work?
Simple. I blink and it starts working.
AumSum. An air conditioner has three main parts. Firstly, evaporator, which is located inside the house. Finally, compressor and a condenser, which are usually located outside. When hot air from the room flows over the cold, low-pressure evaporator coils, the liquid refrigerant, which is present inside the coils, absorbs this heat and starts getting converted to gaseous state. Now, this gaseous refrigerant passes through the compressor, which puts it under high pressure and converts it back to liquid state. The extra heat which is generated during this process is let out using the condenser coils and an outdoor fan. This cycle keeps on repeating itself. This is how an air conditioner works and our rooms remain cool. What if we had four eyes?
Even I have four eyes. I can see everything.
AumSum. Firstly, If we had four eyes, average players might now become great in sports. Current champions may have to double their training. Secondly, if we had four eyes, thieves will have their task cut out. They may get caught red-handed every single time. Thirdly, if we had four eyes, villains may now have the upper hand. Superheroes might start hiding from them. Fourthly, if we had four eyes, ophthalmologists, as in people who specialize in treating eye-related problems, may double their fees. Fifthly, if we had four eyes, some people may take multitasking to a different level altogether. They may get huge promotions. Lastly, pirates are known to wear a patch over one eye. If we had four eyes, they may have to order more patches.